I'm in the zone now. Nothing can change what we on now. When I pull up, know it's going down. Foot on the gas, ain't no slowing down. Aiming for greatness, no settling.
Yo, it's your boy Jared James Fit here. Welcome back to another video. We're going to be doing something a little bit differently first thing in the morning. I'm going to be hopping on a call with a client. If you guys don't already know, I do online fitness coaching full time. I've been doing it full time for about 2 years now, ever since I moved to Ottawa. Before that, I was doing it part time when I did live in Winnipeg. And I've been doing it part time since 2019. So yeah, we're going to hop on a call with one of my clients, Patty. She's getting ready for a powerlifting meet, and we're just going to go over and make sure we're on the same page before this meet, which is coming up in a couple weeks. I don't know if it's just me, but I always have to have a diet pop whenever I'm working. I don't know, it's just like a little treat for me, and I really enjoy it. It's been a habit of mine for years. I definitely have an addiction to diet pop or energy drinks. What's up?
Just working, working away.
Oh yeah? Do you work from home?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know you worked from home.
Well, we used to wait till dark just to get that fire going. All we need was a spark.
What's up? It's your boy Jared. I figured this would be a good time to talk about taking risks, not only in life, but also in business as well. Figured this would be a good time to mention it because I was talking about how I started my online coaching business, and I wanted to touch on the subject of taking risks. I believe taking risks is crucial for personal growth, innovation, and success. It pushes us out of our comfort zones, allowing us to explore new opportunities and discover our potential. But the biggest mistake that I see, especially younger people make, is understanding your risk tolerance. But I also see this as older people as well. You gotta know what your risk tolerance is. It is absolutely essential before diving into anything new. Knowing your risk tolerance helps you make informed decisions about how much uncertainty you're willing to handle. It's like knowing how much weight you can lift at the gym without injuring yourself. By assessing your risk tolerance, you can avoid making reckless decisions that could lead to unnecessary stress or failure. And trust me, one split-second decision could mess up your entire life if you don't think about it. Our generation, and I find younger generations, are being trained to go, 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 and not think about what they're doing before they do it. When making decisions, consider factors such as your financial situation, personal values, and long-term goals when evaluating your risk tolerance. While some people thrive in high-risk environments, such as myself, others may prefer more stability and security, and that's fine too. Understanding where you fall in the spectrum can guide you in making choices that align with your comfort level and aspirations. Ultimately, taking risks can lead to great rewards, but it's essential to do so wisely. Consider your risk tolerance to ensure a balanced approach to decision-making. Right now, I am talking to myself and I'm giving advice to when I was younger. This is the shit that I wish I knew when I was like 16, 17 years old, but I didn't have anybody tell me these things. I don't know what it is, but sometimes you have to learn the hard way. And I even look back at when I was a kid, I was told a lot of things and I still had to learn the hard way. But I think it's very important to take risks, because it teaches you a very valuable lesson, and I am thankful for that. But at the same time, always consider your risks and if you're willing to make those kinds of risks and what the worst case scenario could happen by making a choice or a decision. Another example of a risk I made was moving to Ottawa. It wasn't easy moving across the province and to an entire different style of living. Like, living out east is completely different than living out west. It forced me to use all my resources, all my valuable skills, such as communication skills. One of them was trying to get a place to live. You know, it's not easy finding a place to live without proof of income and telling somebody that you're gonna move from across the province and live there. Like, it's not easy. So I learned a lot of valuable skills. There's a lot of things that I can't even talk about that I did. I also learned some people are willing to bend the rules to help somebody out. And that's something I learned right away when I moved to Ottawa. I can still remember when Fiona looked at me and she told me, like, how the heck are you gonna do it? Like, what are you gonna do? Like, how are we gonna do this? And I told her, don't think too far ahead. Let's focus on one step at a time and just do what we need to do today. And we did that on repeat, one day at a time. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe. Don't miss out on another video. I upload every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.